it's a massive feat and undertaking what he did to go out of his way to bring those bison back.
Atatitse realized that we had that cultural imperative to save them from extinction.
To get them from the place where they were back to the Flathead Reservation, it's really truly amazing.
It was a taking. It was just like the homestead. Whether you liked it or not, they were going to do it. And you had to find a way to deal with it.
It caused a lot of social strife. It caused economic collapse of what had previously existed. People went from being taken care of and their lifestyle was okay to total poverty. Then, to add further insult to it, they said, you know what, I joked, we want to bring the buffalo back. And we're going to take even more land from you.
The government took many of the same animals that were here and put them back on this land that they took from us.
The notion of bringing them back and bringing them back to the reservation was seen as very positive until they put a fence around it.
The Indians knew, you don't go on the other side of that fence anymore. That's no longer Indian country.
And the tribes at the time exerted a federal principle of self-governance to be able to manage the bison range.
I was raised in central Montana, and I can tell you there was a great deal of misunderstanding in the white world about tribes and about tribal cultures and the interests they had in natural resources.
You've got a lot of good people here, but you still have a few people that really resent the Indian people. And their voices are really loud.
It's not about locking anybody out. It's not about allowing certain people in there. It's about sharing, it's about understanding.
So what better caretakers of keeping buffalo on the landscape in perpetuity than the native people that were here and watched them evolve and assisted with their existence.
They taught us how to survive. We're surviving. And we're going to continue on as long as they're still around.